There's no substitute for experience, as Svetlana Boganskaya proved on the first day of the women's professional gymnastics competition. The veteran of three Olympic Games scored a perfect 10 on her vault and sent notice to her fellow competitors. Next, the spotlight shifted to American Amy Chow, who set the pace on the uneven bars. And Elena Piskun from Belarus also moved into contention with a near flawless routine. On to the balance beam, where Boganskaya again dominated the field. 96 Olympic gold medalist Shannon Miller had some uncharacteristic troubles. And Dominique Dawes found herself off the mark as well. On the floor exercise, Dominique Mocianu rallied with her best showing of the day. But once again, the gymnasts were forced to try and keep pace with the leader, Boganskaya. She was the best on the floor and firmly established on top. Now, in the final day of competition, can experience prevail again? Today, the CBS Sports Show comes to you once again from Rochester, Minnesota, on the banks of the Zumbro River. They call it the All-American City. We're at the Mayo Civic Center, where some of the world's top gymnasts are getting set for the second day of competition at the Women's Professional Gymnastics Championship. Hello, everyone. I'm Andrea Joyce. Well, for the women, the average age of the Olympic gymnast in Atlanta was 17 years old. But here at this professional championship in Rochester, youth has been overshadowed by a seasoned veteran. As we enter this second and final day of competition here, it is the oldest, most experienced gymnast at the top of the leaderboard. 24-year-old three-time Olympian Svetlana Boganskaya is in first place, followed by Amy Chow. All eight of the gymnasts here competed in Atlanta. Five of them were members of the American gold medal team. And joining me now, our analyst for this competition, former rhythmic gymnastics champion Wendy Hilliard and 1984 double Olympic gold medalist Peter Vidmar from 1984. And Peter, with gymnastics, we always talk about the youth, the teenagers. How impressed are you by Svetlana Boganskaya?
I'm really impressed. She's in fantastic shape. And yet it's interesting to note that of the two top performers so far, we have two totally different styles of performing gymnastics. Our leader, Svetlana Boganskaya, has done incredibly well in the last couple days of competition, fueled by a perfect 10 in yesterday's vault performance and a 9.9 average in all four events. Once again, she's 24 years old, and yet I think she even looks better now than she did last summer at the Olympic Games in Atlanta. And yet Amy Chow, without that same dynamic expression that you might find in Boganskaya, has been quietly going about the business of executing very clean and technically challenging gymnastics routines, including a very crisp, near-perfect performance on her specialty, the uneven parallel bars. She just missed winning last week's World Professional Gymnastics Championships by 25 one-thousandths of a point. Let's see if she can pull off a victory today.
We should point out, though, that this competition is far from over. And, Wendy, you can never count out a couple of other veterans, Dominique Dawes and Shannon Miller.
Well, you've got that right. Both Shannon and Dominique know how to win. And they may be using a second-day go-all-out strategy to take full advantage of this professional competitive format. Ultimately, the outcome of this competition will be determined on the balance beam and floor exercise. Shannon Miller, the Olympic gold medalist on the balance beam, has the edge in that event. And Dominique Dawes, whose fall off the beam last weekend cost her the title, is determined not to make that mistake. So if she's in the final event, the floor exercise, she has the advantage due to her explosive tumbling.
And while the gymnasts are warming up for today's competition, we want to take a few moments to look back at how well Svetlana Boganskaya performed yesterday. We start her sensational day on vault. Here's how Peter, Wendy, and I called it. Here's Svetlana Boganskaya.
Now on the vault, please welcome
three-time
Svetlana
Olympian. Competed in 88, 92, and 96. Won the gold medal on vault in 1988.
Another great Yurchenko half-turn vault. Very difficult to land. She's very excited about that.
Svetlana Boganskaya, the 1988 Olympic gold medalist on the vault.
Now you can see how powerful she is. She's starting with the round off, going right to a back handspring, and because she has to turn half and land front, which she does, great. That makes it that much more difficult. It is worth a 10. Here's another look. You can see her body position. Legs nice and tight together, and a great landing.
Best vault of the day so far.
And the highest score on vault so far, 9.975.
Well, tell me if that doesn't take the pressure off for the next vault. So impressive. This is a career that spanned three Olympic Games. And we talk so much about gymnastics for women as a young person's sport, but she's 24 years old.
And she still knocks out two great vaults. The same vault, worth a 10. It's going to be hard to beat that one.
I think that was better than the first one. Let's see what the judges say.
Let's take another look. It's like a textbook. Here she's going for the round off onto the horse, and look at the body position, very straight, and she just lands it, and it's so tough to land the front landing vault. Here she is again. You can see the position here of her legs, nice and tight, and she just rocks that landing.
And the score for Boganskaya, a 10. Up now, Svetlana Boganskaya. She was the 1991 world champion on beam.
And talk about deliberate. Look at all of her motions. She knows exactly what she's doing in every skill. Just attacks it.
Back handspring, back layout. And the thing is, Svetlana really knows her gymnastics quite well. That's why she's been able to sustain for so long. She knows which moves are consistent for her, and she knows what looks good.
Yes, she does. She really performs to more than the judges. The crowd really likes to watch her really go through these movements.
Front tuck, nice technique, very solid.
Looks like her feet are glued to the beam.
Gymnasts wish they could glue their feet to the to the beam. Look at that extension, right to the back, walk over down to the beam. A little Svetlana style there on the bottom of the beam. Full turn, requirement in every athlete's routine on the balance beam.
Now, she worked this double back dismount many, many times in warm-up. Let's see what happens here. And the hard work paid off. Look at that. Perfect landing. This could stick her back up on top. That was a great routine.
Well, if she scores better than a 9.975, she would take the lead from Amy Chow.
Here's her mount. You can see how she's concentrating. Front flip onto the beam, and then she actually adds a little wolf jump for a combination. From the overhead shot, you can see from the handstand, she's gonna go back, back handspring, back layout. And here she goes for her dismount. She was a little bit off to the side. I think she was very surprised that she pulled it off.
The score.
Can't do much better than this. It's a 9.975 for Boganskaya. And just to let you know how dominant Svetlana Boganskaya was, those were the two highest scoring performances of the day. When we come back, we'll see Boganskaya's floor exercise, and Michelle Tafoya will speak with the leader.
The Women's Professional Gymnastics Championship is sponsored by OB Tampons. OB, so you're worry-free. Old Spice High Endurance Deodorant. For long-lasting odor protection, now you've got proof, not promises. And by Desinex, the soothing cure for athlete's foot.
Welcome back to the Women's Professional Gymnastics Championship. As the gymnasts continue to get ready for today's competition, we want to take another look at how the leader, Svetlana Boganskaya, did on floor yesterday. Here's how Wendy, Peter, and I called it. Up next, Svetlana Boganskaya. She won the silver on the floor in the 88 Olympics, a world champion on the floor in 1989. Amazing longevity.
And this is really one of her trademarks, is how she moves, her own style.
Svetlana actually retired after the 1992 Olympics. She took a couple of years off, launched a comeback in 1995, moved to Houston, and has been training with Bella Caroli ever since.
And I'll tell you, she looks better than she did in Atlanta. She really does.
Beautiful front series pass. And now Svetlana's going to be performing with the Anti-Gravity Gymnastics Dance Company. So something new on her plate because she's such a great performer. She knows how to get the crowd going too. Final pass, back handspring, tough double, very nice feet.
Svetlana Boganskaya getting a standing ovation from some of the folks here in Rochester, Minnesota. Very appreciative of the reception she's getting here.
Here's her runoff, whip through, back handspring, double tuck. Good tumbling passes, but really gets that credit on her dance, too. The final is just another double tuck, but she fulfills all of her requirements and just really gets the crowd on her side, too. She's going to score well here.
And the score for Boganskaya, 9.90, so a very consistent first day for Svetlana Boganskaya. And she moves into the lead with that 9-9. So Boganskaya takes that lead now into this final day of competition. Her lead over Amy Chow, 25 one-thousandths of a point. The fourth member of our broadcast team, Michelle Tafoya, is with the leader now backstage.
Well, Svetlana Boganskaya's first round of competition started off with a perfect 10 on vault, three first place finishes in three of the four events. How were you able to put together such a complete first day?
I was concentrating on my routines and I was trying to do my best and enjoying myself.
Today, you go in as the veteran. How much will that experience help you, and what's your approach going to be to this second round?
Well, I'll try to do the same as I did the last day, the day before today, and I'll try to do my best, I guess.
But something seems to be going particularly well for you at this competition. What do you think it is?
I think it's a crowd that helped me a lot.
You're enjoying them?
Yes, definitely.
Good luck the rest of the way.
Thanks.
And thank you, Michelle. We'll be back with the start of today's competition, The Vault, in a moment. Welcome back to the Women's Professional Gymnastics Championship. Here's how the competition works. This is the second day of this two-day event. Six rotations. After the second rotation today, the top six scores advance to a semifinal beam off. At that point, the scores are zeroed out. The top four scores on beam go on to the finals, the final floor. Once again, the scores are zeroed out. The competitor with the highest score on floor is the women's professional gymnastics champion. The standings now, once again, Boganskaya on top, Mocianu and Poliskova on the bubble trying to secure a top six spot. Today, just two more rotations for all eight competitors, vault and bars, then the field gets smaller till we crown a champion. The competition order now for the vault, Boganskaya will lead off. Svetlana started off so strong yesterday, really set the tone, and she looked great in the warm-ups here today.
She did. She had a very perfect vault, even in the warm-ups, as good as she did when she scored the 10 yesterday. Here it goes. Little step backwards.
Svetlana won the gold medal on vault in 1988. She was just 15 years old. In 1992, she won the silver on vault at the World Championships.
And here you see she's doing a Yurchenko with a half twist, which is very difficult to land, and she really was just a little short, which is why she had to take those two steps. Here she is again, round off onto the board, pushes off, and right there you can see she just couldn't quite get the landing, had to take that step.
First score of the day, a 9.850 for Svetlana Boganskaya.
All of these gymnasts will be competing by modified NC2A rules, and they are allowed two vaults, and they get the best score from the best vault. Yurchenko half again, and that was much better.
Yeah, much better, much more height, more distance. Not quite the perfect vault she did in yesterday's competition, but it's better than the one she just did earlier. Should score a 9.9 or better. Let's see what the judges say. Much better approach. Gets good lift, gets good distance from the horse. Just in much more control on the landing. But that hop is still a deduction. She can't get the 10.
Boganskaya's second vault scores a 9.90. Up next, Shannon Miller, currently in fifth place. She has had an amazing gymnastics career, 7 Olympic medals from the 92 and 96 games.
Shannon is going to be performing the same vault, Yurchenko with a half twist. She's been a little close during the warm-ups. Let's see how she performs. Ah. Those three big steps. Unfortunately, the distance from the horse wasn't far, and that's going to be about 2 or 3 tenths deduction.
I think that Shannon was surprised at how soon the ground came up on her. She comes around here and braces herself a little bit too late. The ground came up so soon, it surprised her. She stumbled backwards. Was fine in the air, but just wasn't ready at all for that landing.
And Shannon scores a 9.75. Shannon has been bothered a little bit by a sore upper arm, her left arm, also by some tendonitis in her wrist.
This shouldn't affect her so much for this event, and she has one in the bag, and she just wants to try and get a little bit more distance from the horse and land it better. Oh, and there she has two more big steps, so she actually compensated in the other direction.
Almost looked a little bit tired on the landing. I was surprised. She actually did this vault perfectly in the warm-up right before. But did her legs almost buckle on the impact here? Comes around, and they just buckle on her. This is not really par for the course for Shannon Miller. Usually she's more solid on this landing.
Shannon Miller with a 9.70 on that second vault. Her best vault yesterday was a 9.9. Here's Dominique Dawes now, 20 years old, a 3-time national champion on vault.
Dominique's going to be performing a handspring front with a pike, which is worth a 10-0. Let's see how she does it. Now that's really sticking the landing. I think she was surprised there. She could have used a little bit more plié to control the landing, but it wasn't a bad ball. One small step.
She might be in a little bit of pain. Dominique has been bothered by tendonitis in her right ankle, and it affected her preparation for today.
Yes, competing with an injury always affects your concentration and focus.
Good form, just like she was kind of shocked by the landing as well.
And the score for Dominique Dawes.
First ball for Dawes, 9.85. And she does look like she's hurting. You can see she has tears in her eyes.
Ready for the second ball.
It is so tough to keep your concentration, as I mentioned before. You can see she's obviously in pain, but right now she just wants to keep it all together and try and improve on that first vault. Another nice front handspring pipe, but those steps on the end are going to really be costly.
Dominique performed well on the vault yesterday, a 9.95, but once again, that injured ankle obviously bothering her.
And that could be a factor as we approach the last few events if she goes on to beam and especially on the floor. So she needs to make sure that she keeps that ankle healthy enough to do some good routines towards the end here.
And the judges award Dawes a 9.7 for that second vault. Still to come, we'll see how Dominique Mociano does as she tries to hang on to that important sixth place after this message and a word from your local station. Check out the CBS Sports Line for a brand new gymnastics site. You'll find in-depth bios, plus visit Bella Caroli. It's all there and it's fast at cbs.sportsline.com. Getting set to vault now, 15-year-old Dominique Mociano. Always one of the most popular gymnasts at these competitions.
She's going to perform a Yurchenko with a full twist and a very nice landing. The key is that it's a little bit easier to land that than what Svetlana and Shannon did, and this vault is only worth a 9.9.
The youngest national champion in history at the age of 13.
Here's her nice approach, a good crisp full twist. Doing it backwards on the landing allows her to see the ground as she comes down to it, unlike the half turn, when it's impossible to see the ground until the gymnast lands.
And the score first vault for Mociano, a 9.80. That was her best vault score yesterday.
So if she can land this without taking an extra step, she can go for the 9.9. Same vault. Does a round off as she approaches the horse, back onto it, and a much better landing. Much better.
Well, that'll help Mociano as she tries to secure a top six spot. She's currently on the bubble.
Houston, Texas.
We'll take a look as she comes into the vertical position. After she does the first flip, she comes around. If we stop it right there, she can see the ground here. She's got a clear sight towards the ground. That enables her to come down and land perfectly. She knows where the ground is when she does the full twist.
And the score
for, and the score for Mociano, a 9.875. Here's Elena Piskun. She was a member of the 1996 Belarus Olympic team. Get a chance to watch her last week in Portland, guys, and she is a very solid gymnast.
She's really solid all around, just an incredibly powerful performer. Look at this Yurchenko full twist, little hop, nicely done vault.
In 1993, Elena Piskun was the world vault champion, and in 1996, she was the world unofficial.
Here she's approaching the horse, and right there. Good position in the air, straight legs, just one little hop on the landing. Gets the punch off the horse in really good air position, as I said.
The score for Elena
and Piskun scores a 9.85.
Vault, the same vault. Oh, actually, she did it with a half twist.
Didn't change.
Yes.
Did the half turn.
Adding that half turn in there ups the level of the vault to a 10, and she did it quite well.
We mentioned yesterday the gym in her hometown is so small it doesn't have room for a floor exercise mat, nor does it have room for a vault runway.
Not suffering too much, though. Just a little hop on the landing, but nonetheless, it was a very good vault, and she should score higher than her previous vault just because that level of difficulty raises it a tenth of a point.
And it's a 9-9 for Pisgoon. Up now, Pisgoon's Olympic teammate, Alona Poloskova. Currently in seventh place, she needs to pick up some ground here in this rotation.
And she's really gaining much more experience internationally. And she's doing a front pike. Very nice position. She had great distance away from the horse, and it's worth a 10. She should score well.
I think he chose to do that, though, because it is worth a 10.0. And knowing how close she is to Dominique Mociano, she needs to get a little higher score here. Good vault, good angle and everything, but that little hop's going to cost her, so she can't get that 10. Little straddle on the pre-flight as well.
And the score for Alona. First vault for Alona, 9.825. That's better than her two vaults yesterday. High score yesterday was a 9.8.
She's going to go for the same vault. She just has a couple of slight corrections that can really up that score. Same vault, much better landing. Let's see what the judges say.
Like many gymnasts from the former Soviet Union, Alona started gymnastics very young, 4 years old. She likes them all.
You can see here, she still has that separation in her legs, but her landing was much better. Very small hop. Just that one separation, and you can see the landing. She was really able to make it very solid.
Poloskova with a 9.9, and that's higher than Mociano's 9.875, the gymnast she's chasing for that all-important sixth spot. Coming up, she's known for her quiet power, Amy Chow on the vault when we return. Back at the Women's Professional Gymnastics Championship, a milestone this weekend for Amanda Borden as she celebrated her 20th birthday with her fellow gymnasts.
Better than ever. Thanks, John.
Zoom in.
Happy birthday, Amanda and Amy.
Don't spit on each other when you do it.
Wait. Ready? One, two, three.
Thought I'd drop a Latin to say that I wish
And we wish Amanda a very happy birthday as well. Nothing we can do, though, about her eighth place standing right now. We'll see how she does on vault.
And her vault is a handspring front with a tuck position, but because it's tucked, it's only worth a 9.9. And she has one step, so she's going to have to improve on that landing to help her score.
Well, yesterday she was only able to score a 9.675 on the vault. Her downfall, though, was really the fall off the balance beam.
And here's her handspring tuck front. Opens up a little bit too late and has to take that step forward. I think she sees the writing on the wall because there have been so many good vaults before her. She's going to have to really pull off a great uneven bar routine, and someone's going to have to make a mistake for her to move up into that sixth place spot.
The judges award Borden a 9.725.
She's going to do the same vault for her second vault. And if she can really just control that landing, she can maybe gain a tenth. Still has that one big step, so it's going to be hard for her to move up during the vault.
Amanda Borden with her coach Mary Lee Tracy. They've been together since she was 13 years old.
Pretty much the same vault as the last one. Gets plenty of rotation, but opens up a little bit too late. Has to take that step forward.
The timing is the key. If you open up too early, you're just going to sit down, but Amanda held on too much and had to take that extra step.
And the score for Amanda Borden. And it's a 9.75 for Amanda Borden, so that will not help her cause much. In fact, she lost some ground in this vault rotation. Last up on vault, Amy Chow in second place. Amy won the gold medal on vault at the 1995 Pan Am Games.
And she does a handspring pike front half twist called a Barani. Takes a big hop backwards. She kind of whipped it around and pulled her legs right in. As a result, she had to hop backwards.
Because the handspring, little leg separation there, you can see where she pulled it over. Not over, took the big step back, but as you can see from this view, she also is not centered when she takes a hop way over to the side.
And the score for Amy Chow.
Amy Chow's first ball to 9.85. So Amy loses a little bit of ground to Svetlana. We'll see how she does here now on her second vault.
Well, if she hits it, this vault is worth a 10. And that was a much better vault. She must be listening to me after that.
Now, this is a vault that is similar to Dominic Luciano's in terms of the landing, because she can see the ground as she comes around to land. As we stop it when she's upside down after completing the vault, there's a handspring pike front. There's the half turn. She's upside down. She can see the ground again in this position. She can look right down on the ground and then zero in on the landing. That's why a half turn on a front vault is easier to land.
And the score,
Amy Chow scores at 9.95. And that'll be good enough for her to take the lead over from Svetlana Boganskaya. The standings now after the vault, Amy Chow in first place over Boganskaya. Dominique Mociano has been able to hang on to that all-important sixth place spot. When we come back, the women move to the uneven bars. We'll see Dominique Dawes and Shannon Miller in a moment. Rochester, Minnesota is home of the world-famous Mayo Clinic. The U.S. Olympians ventured out into the city's 47 miles of hospital hallways to visit patients, and they did some other sightseeing. Amanda Borden tells us about it.
Whoa! It was a great movie.
It's always a lot of fun and laughs when I get together with my Olympic teammates. While we were here in Rochester, we knew there was a special group of gymnastics fans who couldn't come out to see us perform. So we decided to go see them, and we took a ride over to the Mayo Eugenia Litta Children's Hospital. My life has been filled with good health and good fortune, and wherever we go, we enjoy the opportunity to give something back to someone who's been less fortunate. Gives you a real good feeling inside to touch someone's life and put a smile on a child's face. We all feel this special event scored a perfect 10 for everybody.
And there's Ashley Crawford, one of the young patients who enjoyed the gymnast visit and is truly enjoying today's competition. With one more rotation remaining for all eight gymnasts, Amy Chow is in the lead. Dominique Mociano hanging on to that sixth spot. Here's the competition order for the bars. Mociano up third, not the best spot as she tries to build a high score, but she does have sixth place right now. Shannon Miller will start off the bars rotation. She won the bronze medal in this event in Barcelona in 1992.
Shannon is consistent on all the events, and so if she just has no major mistakes, she should score well on this routine. These athletes have to have two releases. There's one, Ginger, and they also have to work on the high and the low bar.
Shannon told us that she really enjoyed touring the country with the other gymnasts the last several months, but not training as much as she did perhaps a year ago.
And Shannon can train. That's one athlete who can work real hard.
Absolutely. 8 hours a day, she said before. And
great nice routine. Landing.
Great routine.
Shannon had a solid but not spectacular day yesterday.
And all that means nothing now because she starts from a clean slate on the beam.
This is the first release move. It's called a ginger. Very clean, good position all the way to the toe point.
American gymnast in history.
The second move is called a takacha or a reverse head. And you see her form stays throughout. She goes down to the low bar. The dismount for this one is what we call a toe on. She's going for a front flip with a half twist so she can spot the ground.
And the score.
Ann Miller gets back on track with a 9-9 on bars. Next up, Dominique Dawes, three-time national champion on bars. She has been very focused at this competition, scored a 9.825 on the uneven bars in the first day of competition.
There's a reason why. She's very dynamic on bars. What's nice is that she's such a tall gymnast for a female gymnast, and it looks really nice to be able to do big skills on the uneven bars, nice and big. Good fluid swing. Here's a giant setting up for a double back dismount. Not the hardest routine she's done, but I think she's doing what it takes to get her into the next round of competition.
As long as she stays in the top six, which she will, she can start all over. The scores are zeroed out in the next rotation.
Here she shoots over the low bar. Little glide kick, fulfilling the requirement to go down to the low bar. Most of the skills, as we see now in women's unevens, is done on the high bar. Her dismount is just a double tuck. Not super difficult, and she lands it quite easily.
But Dominique was struggling with an ankle injury after the vault, but we can't really tell if it's bothering her now. She scores a 9.875 on the bars and has no trouble advancing to the semis. Up next, Dominique Mocianu. Currently in sixth place, she needs better than a 9.825 to make it to the semis. This is not her favorite nor her best event.
But she still does it quite well. She got the reverse head over the bar. And as you mentioned, this is very important. So she's hitting everything, keeping her rhythm moving. Here she's setting up for a dismount. Double layout, looks for the ground, very nice routine.
Bars was her lowest score of the competition yesterday, 9.675. We'll see how she does here today when the pressure is a little bit greater.
And she made a mistake on this event in yesterday's competition. There was her reverse hecht. The mistake came after her second release move, which is that flyaway half turn, the ginger. There's the ginger. And she shoots over the low bar. She bent her legs there yesterday, made it just fine today. She'll get a much better score today as well.
And it is a substantial improvement for Mocianu, a 9.85, and that will clinch a spot for her in the semifinals. Still to come on the bars, Elena Piscoon, after this message and a word from your local station. That's the Zumbro River here in Rochester. As we continue the Women's Professional Gymnastics Championship, Michelle Tafoya is with one of the semifinalists.
Well, Dominique Mocianu entered the day in sixth place. Strong performances on vault and bars, not one of your favorite events, but you knew you needed it to lock into that sixth spot.
Yeah, I did, and I just went out there and did my best, and it turned out pretty well, so I'm happy.
And it turns out that no competitor can catch up with you now. You're in that next round, and it's the beam off. What do you have planned for that?
I'm going to do the same routine as I did the other day, and I'm ready for it, and hope it goes well.
Good luck.
Thanks.
All right, thanks, Michelle. Elena Piskun getting ready now for her bars routine. She was the world champion in this event last year.
Here she's going for her first release move. She has a full over the top, giant and hop full, very nice combination. And look at that delta all the way. And look at the position on the low bar. Everything she does is very clean and crisp. There's her giant swing, setting up her dismount. Double layout, very nice landing, little leg separation, but that was a real nice routine.
Tremendous performance.
Piskun getting a hug from her Olympic teammate from last year, Svetlana Boganskaya.
This Delchev is really amazing. It's a flyaway half turn, straddle position. She goes way over the bar and then rocks it to the handstand on that low bar. The margin for error there is so slight. Did it just right.
Here we have that dismount, double layout, little leg separation, but the landing is perfect.
Yeah, I don't think she'll get a deduction for that.
And the judges award Piskun with a perfect 10 for that bars routine, the first 10 of today's competition. Here's Ilona Poliskova. Once again, even a perfect score on the bars would not put her in the semifinals. Dominique Mocianu once again secured the number 6 spot.
Beautiful Ginger. I think Ilona is really working to the future. In Belarus, she's the number 2 on the national team, and she's gaining a lot of experience as she is here today so that she can up her ranks internationally.
Really a clean, solid performance. I mean, she was really skying those release moves. Her double layout was crisp. She's someone to definitely watch in the future. Very exciting gymnastics.
She made her international debut at the World Championships in 1994. She was just 14 years old and came in 13th in the all-around.
Here's a look at her first release move. Ginger, very nice form, keeping her feet together, tough to do, down to the low bar. Here she's going to do a double layout. She has great height, and she just has a small hop on the landing.
And Ilona scores a very respectable 9.85, but that is the last we will see of this young woman from Belarus. Amanda Borden up now. Like Ilona Poliskova, she cannot make the top 6. Still a very tough competitor, though. Amanda would like to go out with a strong performance here on bars.
There's your glide kick up to the high bar.
We can't feel sorry for Amanda, though, not making the semifinal round. Her life has been very rich since the Olympic Games. She's been doing television commercials, touring with the other gymnasts, speeches, even worked for CBS as a commentator on the cheerleading championships.
And doing a nice routine so far here. Here's her front half dismount. That's still going to score very well. Nice way to finish off this competition for her.
Since the Olympics, she spent a lot of time speaking to youth groups, schools about nutrition and sports.
Next January, Amanda will also add college to her list of activities.
There's her Jaeger Salto, nice and high over the bar. Dismount was a toe on front with a half twist, sees the ground. Right there, she's upside down. She can see where the landing should go. She'll score well there.
And the judges award Amanda 9.85. So Amanda Borden finishes in last place, but has the satisfaction of ending with her best mark of the competition. Coming up, Amy Chow and Svetlana Boganskaya continue to battle it out for the lead. Stay with us. Amy Chow ready for her bars routine. Amy won the silver medal on the bars in Atlanta. This is her strongest event. And she had the top bars score yesterday, 9.95.
She's going to have to be perfect here, though, in order to try to get that 10 and tie for the highest score. Already we've got a 10 on bars. Let's see what Amy can do. Beautiful pike front flip right down to the low bar. I thought that her performance in Atlanta really was good enough to have won that gold medal. She did a great dismount there, full in back out. In Atlanta, she did that with an extra twist, but still, she's really in control on uneven bars. It shows in her performance, and she's gonna score very well here. Let's see what the judges give her.
Last year, Amy was the first Asian American to win an Olympic gymnastics medal.
And here you're seeing a release move, the front flip with a pike, which makes it very, very difficult right down to the low bar. And Amy Chow was one who does a lot on the low bar. It's very innovative and very refreshing, not a stock routine. Her dismount is a double back with a full twist, but at the Olympics, she did the same thing with two twists, and it's named after her, called the Chow 2.
And Chow scores a 9.95 on the bars. Here's Svetlana Boganskaya. Bars was her weakest event on day one, scored just a 9.725 yesterday, but she's not in danger of missing the cut, so it's really better for her that bars is in this rotation and not in the semifinals or the finals.
It's great to get out of the way here so that she can be really primed for beam and floor, which are two of her better events.
But anything Svetlana does, she looks good. She's got such great technique, beautiful line and the legs and the toes.
I think she lacks some of the raw power of the smaller gymnasts that are here, but she tries to make up for it with her style. Good double layout dismount. That was great.
You call it her weakest event, but she doesn't look very weak on it at all. This is actually the only event that she doesn't have an Olympic or a world championship medal in.
Just a great body line, good toe point, very fluid movement. Not packed with some of the difficulty you might see in a routine like Amy Chow's. But her dismount was very impressive. Did that double layout, which is hard for a taller gymnast like her. Whips it around for a great landing.
And Svetlana scores a 9.90. Continues to make a statement here in Rochester. Lost a little bit of ground to Amy Chow, but the scores all zeroed out now for the top six competitors. So there you see the standings after the six rotations. Those top six gymnasts will advance now to the semifinal round. Alona Poloskova and Amanda Borden are out. The top six gymnasts getting ready now for the beam off. We'll be back in a moment. Back at the Women's Professional Gymnastics Championship, the field is narrowed to six. As the gymnasts get set for the semifinal beam off, let's check in with Michelle Tafoya.
With two of the final six competitors, Dominique Dawes, the slate is clean now, so the beam becomes very important. Your ankle's been bothering you just a little bit. How do you expect that to affect you on beam?
Well, I want to go warm up and see how it's going to feel and just go out and try the best job that I can.
The beam was the thing that got you a little bit last week in Portland. It was the one thing that knocked you out of competition. Is that playing on your mind at all?
Well, no, I definitely put that behind me. That was a mistake that I just want to put behind me, and I want to think of what I want to do today.
Good luck to you. Turning now to Shannon Miller. Again, the slate is clean. You were last week's champion. This week's scores have not gone quite as well for you, but like I said, the slate is clean. What do you have planned for the beam?
Right now, I'm just going to warm up and do the very best routine I can and hopefully hit it and then move on to the floor exercise.
When you move onto the floor, tell us a little bit, if you move onto the floor, what we can expect.
Well, hopefully it'll be a lot more fun routine. It'll be a performance routine, and hopefully the audience will get into it.
Good luck to you.
Thank you.
All right, thanks, Michelle. Last week in Portland, Peter had a chance to sit down and chat with the legendary Bella Caroli, said he was kind of retired. Here's more of that conversation now, including talk of Bella's former proteges.
Bella, you've coached some of the biggest names in women's gymnastics, Nadia Comaneci, Mary Lou Retton, Kim Zemeskal, recently Dominique Mociano, Kerry Strug. Do you have the formula for success in women's gymnastics?
It's a pretty complicated process. There's a lot of ingredients into it. The one needs to come somehow from the personality of the coach, somehow the circumstances, somehow the historical moment, and also it's a big weight on the success is the natural talent of the athlete, the one they're working with.
Let's talk about your gymnasts. If you could name certain qualities of certain athletes, who would you say is the hardest working gymnast you've ever coached? Hardest working.
Hardest working is Nadia, was the hardest working person. Of course, that was the time when I was younger. And probably I implemented this hardworking atmosphere even more than ever in my life because I wanted to tear down the mountain. And the kids responded very nicely. And she was one of them, the one who 100% responded. She was the hardest working person.
Now, does the hardest working person mean they're also the easiest to work with? Who was the easiest to work with in the gym?
Easy, I won't be able to say, but the most pleasant one who I ever worked was Mary Lou. No doubt about that. I'm still calling her the sunshine of my coaching career because of her open personality. This is joking way of, oh, she is always taking the things in the natural, open way. You know, her open mouth and open heart always delighted, and I was lighted up the gym. And no matter how bad mood even I'm in, I never could be mad at her because she was just so natural. So honest.
Well, as you know, every 4 years, there is always a time when women's gymnastics is put under a microscope.
Right.
Much more so than in the years in between the games. Along with that comes some criticisms of women's gymnastics, the demands that are placed on these young girls. And some of those criticisms have been directed towards your coaching style. How do you respond to those comments? And what is Bella's coaching style? What is your coaching style?
It's interesting to see, wherever you're successful, how immediately criticism comes around. No matter what you're producing, no matter what you're being positive or less positive, criticism will come. And my criticism was about the strict discipline style, the one I directed and I implemented in the gym in order to achieve those goals. But I have to tell you, no matter how much criticism would come, without discipline, hard work, dedication, you would never be competitive with the best among the best. We're talking about the best in the world. We're not talking about a dilettante, recreational type of activity where the people can come, have a little fun, go around. No, we are talking about probably the most strenuous and the toughest effort that a human being can produce in order to prove, yes, I'm the best among the best. And that was the goal, to be best among the best in the United States of America. So the American kids had to understand, and they had to understand, without hard work and dedication, this will never be achieved. Criticism came, I took it, but I will never agree with those ones who said, by the easy and the pleasant way, you can achieve something which is outstanding.
Hard work and determination, that pretty much describes the typical Bella Caroli gymnast. We'll be back with the semifinal beam off after this message and a word from your local station. This final day at the Women's Professional Gymnastics Championship began with Svetlana Boganskaya looking solid again on vault. Amy Chow was near perfect with a 9.95. On the uneven bars, Shannon Miller was right on track, keeping pace with the leaders. And Elena Piskun found perfection and was rewarded with a 10. Welcome back to Rochester, Minnesota and the Women's Professional Gymnastics Championship. Andrea Joyce along with Peter Vidmar and Wendy Hilliard. Wendy, we're down to six competitors. The semifinal beam off. Who's got the edge?
Well, on balance beam, anything can happen. One fall and it'll take them out of the whole competition. But I would have to say Shannon Miller and Dominique Dawes. And the thing is, whoever does well on the beam, it will affect the final outcome of the competition.
And then the final rotation is on floor. Peter, last week in Portland, we saw four perfect tens on the floor. So that could be a real showdown.
That's right, because all four of those tens are competing on the beam to go back to the floor exercise for the finals. Svetlana Boganskaya, Amy Chow, Dominique Dawes, Shannon Miller, they all scored perfect tens. One of the reasons is that those floor routines now have vocals in the music. As a result, it's going to be a unique format for floor exercise, probably the most exciting part of the competition.
And Peter, will also have theatrical lighting for the final rotation on the floor. Here's the competition order meantime for this semifinal beam off. The gymnasts will perform in reverse order according to their finish in the first six rotations. So the leader, Amy Chow, has the advantage of competing last. Remember, all the gymnasts are equal now. The scores are back to zero. Let's head backstage now to Michelle Tafoya.
With Amanda Borden, who unfortunately did not make the final six. You were a long shot coming into the day, but what did or did not go particularly well for you?
Well, today went great. It was the preliminary day. I had a mistake on the balance beam, and that definitely cost me.
All right, who's left out there that's very strong on beam, and who do you like going into the floor?
Well, I don't have a favorite, but it's definitely going to be a tight competition. The balance beam is the event that makes or breaks who's going to be the winner, and so whoever stays on the beam will probably have a great chance at winning.
Svetlana Boganskaya has been so strong throughout this competition. Is it amazing for someone of your age to watch someone of her age still perform at that level?
It's definitely an inspiration. I know that I want to be able to compete when I'm 24 years old, so I watch her and I know that I want to go back to the gym and just continue to train.
Thanks for joining us.
Thank you.
And we begin the women balance beam.
Up first on the beam now, Dominique Mocianu. The lights have dimmed. We have theatrical lighting now for this semifinal rotation. How difficult does that make it for the gymnasts?
Well, I think these athletes, because they've been performing on tour for the past few months, are a little bit more used to it. But anytime the light changes, you really have to change your focus here. And I think right now, fortunately, they are used to it, but it is a challenging element that you have to work with.
And sometimes with the lighting too, it's if it casts a shadow that they're not used to, it can throw them off in terms of the perception of whether they're on. But looks fine right there. Great back hamstring, back layout sequence.
We talked about the atmosphere at this competition. Not as much pressure as maybe at some other events, but now heading into a semifinal round. First one up on the beam, I would think that this 15-year-old is feeling a little bit of pressure out there.
And Dominique's really kind of in between training now because she's preparing for the national championships. Her routine is kind of a combination of the rules she'll need for next year and yet the rules that are modified for this competition. So that adds a little bit more pressure also. There we have a little bobble there on her flip-flop quarter.
Dominique is a 10th grader. She studies through correspondence courses. She's nice landing. Also an author who authored her autobiography. It was number 7 on the New York Times bestseller list for a while. She looks relieved.
Here's her first back handspring combination. It's a back hamstring step out, back layout, into another back layout. She gets a little bit off to the left, but look at her just pull her body back in. Sign of experience. Here's that round off back layout with her legs together. Dismount was a double tuck, done very well. She sticks it just right, pulls it around, gets your legs on the floor. Little tiny hop, but good routine.
The judges give Mocianu a 9.80. That's the same beam score she had yesterday. So Mocianu set the pace. And up next, it'll be Shannon Miller. Shannon was a little tentative in the warm-ups on beam. Perhaps bothered by her injury.
And also, Andrew, I think the athletes are a little tired. This is a 2-day competition, and I'm sure they haven't had one of these in a long time. takes a lot more training, so it's going to take a lot more energy for them to really focus on this event, but if anyone can do it, it's Shannon Miller.
Well, that's what happens with the tendonitis in her wrist. It'll flare up every now and then, depending on how busy she's been with competition. And her left upper arm, as we mentioned earlier, has also been bothering her today.
I think it's a combination of a lot of things. I was talking to Steve Nuno, her coach, before this competition, and he said that she had just come back from the, wow, very nice sequence there, though. Just came back from the World Professional Championships and went straight into final exams. Had a couple days of finals, came back, was really kind of tired, and then really only had a good day of training back at her gym before coming out here for this event.
But her Miller, that move right there looked very, very solid, and that is sometimes what affects her wrist. So it looks like she's in pretty good shape riding through here. So far, it's been a very clean routine. I think it will score very well. It's going to be determined about this dismount. She's going to round off, double tuck, and a great landing.
Well, after all that speculation of the tiredness of the injury, she goes out there and rocks a tough routine. That just shows what kind of a competitor she is.
Shannon really put the spotlight on American gymnastics. She won the world championship all-around title in 93 and 94, the only American in history to win two in a row.
This acro sequence begins with a back handspring, and then she does two layout step outs right in a row. Great alignment, and she's right on. Now here's her Miller, back handspring with a three-quarter turn into a beautiful split. Very controlled and very clean. Here's her dismount. She's going round off, tuck double, and watch this landing. She's just solid.
Shannon Miller scores a 9.95 on the beam, and that'll put her in good position to stay in the top four. Here's Dominique Dawes. Dominique, also a three-time national champion on beam.
We'd mentioned earlier about her mistake in last week's World Professional Championships on beam, and yet she doesn't seem to be fazed by it. I think she was kind of irritated that she made that mistake because she wasn't really planning on it. She's pretty solid, and she thinks she feels ready here.
She was solid yesterday on the beam, scored a 9.85.
Oh, that says a lot. Her acro series, back handspring, two layouts. We also talked about her injury, if she has a sore ankle, and we'll really see here if she tries her front somersault, how she's doing. But so far, she's been very consistent and clean on this routine. There's her front somersault. Made it. Solid. Very solid routine. I think she's quite relieved to get that out of the way.
Absolutely.
And Andrew, you talked about how focused these athletes are. Dominique's doing so many things, and then she's also able to train this well in the gym. Really is a testament to the kind of focus and consistency and determination these athletes have.
20 years old, and she still hasn't completely ruled out another appearance in another Olympic Games. Little step on the landing.
Here's an overhead shot of her back handspring combination. Round off, or there's a back handspring, back layout. Here's that front somersault she missed last week. No problem yesterday or today. Dismount's unique in that she does back handsprings into a double back, not a round off like many of the other gymnasts. Took the step in the landing, which will cost her at least a tenth of a point, but she'll still score very well.
And the score for Dominique Dawes.
And for Dawes, it's a 9.825. That's better than Mochianu. Three gymnasts still to come on beam. We'll be back with Amy Chow in a moment.
Next on beam, Elena Piskun.
Next on beam, Elena Piskun. She scored a 9.75 on the beam yesterday. She might have some momentum here, though, with the 10 she scored on bars in the last rotation. Even though those scores don't carry over, I would imagine psychologically they do.
Oh, it's an emotional boost anytime someone scores a 10. It just gets you all fired up. And I mean, she's no slouch on beam either, so.
Elena is the European bronze medalist on beam.
And she has some very interesting and difficult moves on this event. And one of them is coming up. She's going to do a back handspring into a full twist, which is so hard, 4 inches of the beam. And she just sits it. Just, that's to understand how difficult a full twist is on the beam. Doesn't phase her at all. Keeps moving right along with the rest of her routine.
And we talk about her winning a medal at the European Championships. That is a huge, huge gymnastics event. The whole world takes note of who does well at that event because it kind of sets the stage for the upcoming World Championships. And to do well there is a big sign of where she stands right now in the world of gymnastics.
Everything's been great in the routine so far. She's setting up for a dismount. Should score high as double pike. Small little hop, but I think it's going to score very well.
Very good. Very solid performance.
The Belarus Olympians have received a very warm response from the crowd here in Rochester.
Her mount's a tuck front. Has no trouble with it. Gets it right around there. Very solid landing. Unique look on this back hamstring full twist. Look at that. Full turn, right back onto that beam. Amazing. Double pike's a little bit harder than the double tucks we've seen so far. And she has a great landing, just a tiny hop, but she was really in control of that throughout the whole skill.
The score.
And Elena Piskun stays right in it with a 9.85. That's the second best beam score so far. So here are the standings with just two competitors remaining. Shannon Miller on top, Mochianu and Dawes in danger of not making the final cut. Here's Svetlana Boginskaya now.
Please welcome Svetlana Boginskaya.
Performed beautifully on the beam yesterday, had a 9.975. If she scores better than a 9.8 here now, Mochianu will be out.
Boy, that just shows the quality of the competition here, a 9.8 to get eliminated.
If there's one to stay consistent on the beam is Svetlana. She has a lot of really difficult moves, but also she gets a lot of credit from her dance moves and her form on beam. Makes a big difference on this event. Here's her front somersault. Very solid.
And watching her in warm-ups and throughout the competition these 2 days, she's been coached by Bella Caroli recently. And they have an interesting relationship because it seems a little bit different than with some of his other gymnasts. She's 24 years old. She knows what she needs to do in gymnastics, and she and Bella have a very kind of a casual coaching relationship as they talk with each other about how to improve her gymnastics.
He's been her coach since she launched a comeback in 1995. She had retired after the 92 Olympics, took a couple years off, but then came back. Amazing to take 2 years off, 3 years off, and come back and perform at this level.
In gymnastics, it's incredible. Here's her dismount, tuck double, nice landing. It's just amazing how well Svetlana can keep going. At 24, she's just consistent and in great shape.
You see all the gymnasts kind of breathing a sigh of relief as they get off the beam.
Now here's her back handspring. She's taking it from a handstand, starting with one back handspring and then a back handspring layout step out. And the one thing that's great about this dismount, she has good form around here, but the landing, she just knows how to keep from taking an extra step, and that saves tenths.
Boganskaya still waiting for her score. The judge is having a little trouble coming up with a mark. We have four judges here. They determine the score by throwing out the high and low mark and averaging the other two. And Boganskaya scores a 9.80. So she and Mochianu have scored identical 9.80s on the balance beam.
And our final athlete on the beam, Amy Chow.
The last competitor now on beam, Amy Chow. So as long as she scores better than a 9.80, she will advance.
She had a little trouble there with her back layout.
But based on the way the scoring is going, that could be a major problem. She'll lose probably a tenth of a point there, and she really has very little room for error now, even though she's a very strong performer on the beam.
Now that really adds extra pressure in a competition like this. As consistent as Amy's been in the whole competition, as great she's doing, she has hit beam, and there's another mistake where it's going to count. It's going to be tough for her to score very high.
See, this routine is really kind of a new life or sudden death for Amy Chow, so.
These are gym acro combination.
Now, if Amy Chow scores less than a 9.8 here, Mochianu and Boganskaya would be tied for the fourth spot. In that instance, they would go back to all four judges' scores and add in the scores that were dropped.
Her dismount's really going to determine a lot about this score. She's doing a round off double twist. Nice landing. But there were some problems, Peter. She's going to have trouble scoring high on that.
We'll see what happens here. I'll be surprised if she scores better than 9.8.
Very interesting competition. The gymnasts who have been so strong throughout, just one bobble here and there, and they could miss the finals.
And here's her back layout step out. There's that one little bobble, not quite on. Now her dismount is a layout with two twists. She does it without any problem. She never seems to have much trouble with that dismount.
Amy Chow with a 9.85,
wow.
So she survives.
The judges like what she was doing up there, so 9.85 puts her in.
Dominique Mochianu and Svetlana Boganskaya do not make the cut. So the standings now, Shannon Miller, Amy Chow, Elena Piskun, and Dominique Dawes advance to the final rotation, the final floor. Let's head over now to Michelle Tafoya.
Svetlana Boganskaya's 9.80 on beam was not enough to send you to the final floor, as we like to call it. What do you think happened up there?
Well, I'm not sure. I guess I was kind of a little bit nervous because it was a lot of pressure. But I did what I could do, and I tried to do my best, and I guess I did it. But it's difficult to say what happened. You know, it's sport. And a sport can't be without mistakes.
Of the final four competitors on the floor,
yes.
What do you think of the field and who do you like?
Well, to tell you the truth, I can't pick, you know, the best one because I like all of them. They're all my friends, and I wish all of them the best of luck.
Congratulations on a great performance.
Thank you very much.
Coming up, the final four on the final floor. We'll be back with the last rotation in a moment. Back at the Mayo Civic Center in the Women's Professional Gymnastics Championship, here's the competition order now for the final rotation. Once again, in reverse order of how they finished on the beam, Dominique Dawes will go first, followed by Elena Piskun, Amy Chow, and Shannon Miller. There's Svetlana Boganskaya on the sidelines, did not make the cut for the final rotation. Kind of a surprise, particularly since we thought her beam routine was pretty good.
I really have to say I disagree with the judges as far as this is concerned. She was very, very clean, not many deductions, and I'm really going to miss seeing her on the floor. She's one of the best.
Yeah, it would have been nice to see her on floor, but I think what's important is that I think she had all of her elements. She had all of her elements. She did them well, and I was very surprised because she had no visible bobbles or mistakes. She stuck her landing, so it's too bad that she didn't make it into that next round. We're still going to have four great performers on floor, something really to look forward to. But it would have been nice also to see a very unique performance on floor from Boganskaya.
Ladies and gentlemen, the 1996
Once again,
Olympic
first up on the floor,
Dominique Dawes.
She won the bronze medal on the floor in Atlanta. One of the gymnasts to score a perfect 10 on floor last week. And a reminder, you will hear lyrics in the music in this rotation.
The lyrics of Aretha Franklin, Respect. This routine is a lot of fun for the crowd, choreographed by Linda Johnson.
There's her full-in pike. Hey, no problem. Little step on the landing, but I think she's glad to get that over with her little ankle injury.
Now what's important coming up is to see if she's going to do her double tumbling pass. She didn't do it at the last competition. Here she starts, round off, two whips, double twist, punch front, here she goes, classic Dominique. That's such a great series. I think she knows that she needed that to win this competition.
No question.
Dominique, such a terrific performer. She is currently appearing on Broadway in Greece.
And she's not alone on Broadway because Wendy with us here is in the performance of Candide on Broadway. Just saw her and it was great.
Important lyrics are to these routines. It really lets the audience and the gymnasts have a lot of fun.
Here's her final tumbling pass. Hey, double pike. Look at that. Wow. With that hurt ankle, she's doing really well. This is going to be a great scoring routine.
Dominique Dawes, the four-time national champion on floor. Tough to go first, though, in a final rotation such as this with just four competitors.
I think the big concern was with that ankle injury. Can she do her trademark tumbling? And yes, she did. There's a round-off whip, back handspring, double full. Watch this. Punch front and keeps on going into another tumbling pass. We all expect that from Dominique, and she keeps on producing.
And the score for Dawes, a 9.85, so the judges leave some room for the final three competitors. Dominique getting a little work done now on her injured ankle. Up next, Elena Piskun.
Next on the floor from Belarus. Elena Piskun.
Elena, a member of the Belarus Olympic team last year, they came in sixth place in Atlanta in the team competition.
Is a great tumbler. She really does have the potential to throw out some really innovative and hard passes.
And there's a nice 2.5 twist punch. Oh, too bad. Great twisting. Didn't get it around for the front flip, and that's going to definitely cost her this title.
Mm-hmm.
Overall, though, Elena has done so well in this competition. The 10 on the uneven bars, and she had a great beam routine. She's still out there competing on the international circuit, so it's very important for her to get all the requirements in, and she's just still going to be out there with some innovative tumbling.
Well, of all the gymnasts here, she's probably the one that could be the most affected by the different lighting, having not really been on tour as all the other girls have and being able to be exposed to this kind of lighting, and maybe that could have affected her on that pass that she made the mistake on.
Elena Piskun, clearly disappointed with her last performance here in Rochester.
Championships and the 96 Olympics. And what she likes best is the competition itself.
Here's her first tumbling pass, and you can see in the background that's dark around the whole arena. Back handspring, 2.5 twist to a front punch layout, and her feet were just too far in front of her. She really didn't get the momentum to finish forward. Here's her next pass. Bounder fronts, really nice. 1.5 twists, and she looked like she was going to add something onto there, but she was just a little short.
The score.
And for Elena Piskun, it's a 9.375. So Dawes is still the gymnast to beat in this final rotation. Still to come, Amy Chow and Shannon Miller as we conclude this competition. We're back at the Women's Professional Gymnastics Championship. In this final rotation, the leader in the clubhouse is Dominique Dawes.
Next on floor, Amy
Up
Chow.
Now, Amy Chow. The score she needs to beat is a 9.85.
Amy's performing to the Beach Boys, Fun, Fun, Fun. And she does whip through to a full in. Tight full in. Nice first pass.
Amy's made the effort to add a little bit more expression, a little more pizzazz to her routines. I think it's nice to have this music for her to make it look real exciting.
She has shown more emotion out there. In Portland we saw it, and we've seen it here in Rochester.
Oh, very nice layout, triple twist out of that front flip.
For a consistent ending right there. But a lot of fun for this routine.
Nicely done. Amy Chow, she'll be a classmate of Chelsea Clinton's at Stanford in the fall. Wants to be a pediatrician, and the crowd giving her a standing ovation for that floor routine. Amy with her longtime coach, Mark Young. They've been together for 15 years.
Power-packed first pass. Here she goes, round off, whip, back handspring, full in, pike. Not too much trouble, a little stumble on the landing, but boy, she looked great. And here's her round off, back handspring, layout, double twist, finish. Not as difficult nearly as the mount, but she still could score well. Let's see if she does it.
And we have a new leader. The score for Amy Chow, a 9.925.
Ladies and gentlemen,
the last gymnast to compete, Shannon Miller. If she scores higher than a 9.925, she will win the Women's Professional Gymnastics Championship.
All men.
Another fun routine for Shannon. To Greece, choreographed by Geza Pozar. And this shows a different side of Shannon Miller. But to win this competition, you're going to have to hit these tumbling passes.
This will be critical. Pull in, tuck.
Very nice.
No problem.
You can see the crowd really getting into it, and that's Shannon's advantage that she's competing last in the competition.
Shannon scored only a 9.70 on the floor yesterday, but the true competitor that she is, she has stepped up her performances here on the final day of competition.
Sign of a real champion, a true competitor. You do what it takes to win when the time is right, and she's doing it now. Let's see what happens. If she can finish her last tumbling pass, she could do it.
And so far, it's been a very clean performance. All her turns and her dance movements, a lot of fun with the crowd, which is going to go far in this competition. Twist, but overall it was a great performance.
Sure was.
Shannon Miller literally let her hair down for this final rotation. Once again, she needs better than a 9.925 to beat Amy Chow for the title.
Now here's her second and third pass. She's doing whip, whip, back handspring, just a layout, but then she does a punch front and she keeps going the other way. A lot of fun, very exciting, through to a layout step out. Now here's her last pass. Although it did seem simple for these modified rules, this front with a full is what they call a D move, so she does get a lot of credit for that element.
A lot of credit indeed, and the judges award Shannon Miller with a perfect 10. Shannon Miller wins the Women's Professional Gymnastics Championship. So the final standings here in Rochester, Shannon Miller wins the title, Amy Chow in second place, followed by Dominique Dawes and Elena Piskun. Stay with us, golf is next. It's the McDonald's LPGA Championship from Wilmington, Delaware. Michelle Tafoya standing by now with our champion.
Shannon Miller, the champion here. Boy, you scored a little bit low during the primary part of the competition, but when it counted, you nailed your routines.
I was happy to be out there. I enjoy doing gymnastics, and I love doing the floor routine now, and so I was just happy to be out there.
What kind of an advantage did it afford you being the last performer on the floor?
I think it helps a little bit. The crowd gets ready with the first few performers, and then when I went, they were great.
Back-to-back championships. You won this last weekend. Now you win it this weekend. What does that mean to you?
Hopefully it means that I'm still doing well at gymnastics even though I'm 20.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Hardly over the hill, Shannon Miller, two weekends in a row, proves she still has the heart of a champion. For Peter Vidmar, Wendy Hilliard, and Michelle Tafoya, I'm Andrea Joyce saying so long from Rochester, Minnesota.